establish who is on the show tonight, we have Mr. Blargalt, who is our guest and co-host, or part co-host tonight. Would you like to introduce yourself? Say some kind words.
Hi, I'm Blarg. I'm Blarg. I'm, supreme co-host, because that's a title I just made up.
Mm-hmm.
I am, been editing videos for, about close to 2 years, and I've been, enjoying it. It's kind of a sickness. I know, like, you two have probably described it as that. I try to get back to video games and, you know, ponies, but you just keep dragging me back in.
Yeah, that has a typical habit of doing that. Just when you think you're free of the show and the madness, something happens and you're just like, I have an idea for a video, and I have to make it. And I can't stop.
It's true. It's well, you know, sometimes it's a good thing. Sometimes it's mm-hmm. like, hey, am I spending a little bit too much time just like making videos and mm-hmm. stuff for free? But then you realize that it's all worth it.
Yeah. Yeah, so we're going to be following your life and career as a pony video editor, but we can just ask you the first question now. What got you into making videos for this show, Mr. Blargalt?
Well, this was back in, like, I think it was, like, in November, when, like, the fandom was really, really, really young, and people hadn't quite, like, figured out all the nuances and all the characterizations, and, you know, there were a lot of the early meme, and, like, one of the first early ones was the Trollestia thing, you know, where she was evil and would send people to the moon if they did anything to spite her. Yep. So what I did at, like, you know, midnight one night is I just took footage of Princess Celestia, and I set it to Star Control 2 music of the Urquan, which are these, like, evil caterpillars that, you know, enslave races. And, you know, it was kind of popular. It got some views, and I enjoyed making it, even though I did it on Windows Movie Maker. But I had fun. And I just figured, hey, you know, this is kind of fun. I'll do another one sometime. And eventually I did. I think I did one like that was kind of like it with Princess Luna with a slightly different music. And for a while I made a challenge where I would make one a day, but it didn't last very long on that because, oh, that was a hassle. I think I did about 2 months, but yeah.
Yeah,
I couldn't imagine that because it's video editing is already tedious enough, and you're subjecting yourself to completing a video one video a day.
Well, it was to push himself.
How
to be the only one who's done it?
No, I know what he's doing. It's just like I can't imagine. I couldn't even do that. That's insane.
Sure, you could. They just wouldn't be like great necessarily every day. You might have some like gems
exactly.
here and there.
Well, I personally get down on myself about it and be like, I can make this better or something, and it would take me longer than a day. But
see, you got to get out of that mindset when it's 365 days of pony and not necessarily any good. As we have some videos that like he even pulled out a little bit for himself. What was it? The one that was the it was the Celestia one in her idea on the Exquisite Art of PMVs or something like that. I remember that one.
Yeah.
Wait, are we talking about the one that's like 2 seconds long? Because that one's like been haunting me for years.
Yes. It's coming to haunt you again.
Okay, yeah, there's a... Yeah. That was... The story behind that one was I was still doing the one video a day thing, and, yes. Yeah.
Oh, man.
And this thing is going to be edited into my...
It's only 2 seconds long.
Yeah.
Well, but it's 2 seconds long of why PMVs are the source for high art and aesthetic accomplishment. Furthermore.
Yep.
Yeah.
Magical farts.
Good.
Yeah.
Community. Community.
Like, the whole...
To a grinding halt.
The whole point was that I was doing the one video a day thing, and, like, this was, like, later in the day, and I couldn't think of anything funny, so I just did, like, Farting Celestia just because, you know, I just wanted to fill my own quota, and I'm like, oh, fine, here, Farting Celestia, ha, 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 and people loved it. Like, the IRC I frequented, it just kept getting linked and linked, and, you know...
Sees where this community
is like, one of my... Yeah, it's a very big inside joke, but yeah, sometimes it's the little jokes.
have a lot of little jokes. So, a lot of your videos, and you saying during this time period you were making this, like a lot of these videos are just sort of ranging from 2 to even 10 seconds, a little longer than that even, but yeah, it's really not, you know, you just kind of were just going one a day, just, and, that, and you were just trying to find basically really little jokes within the show itself, and that's a style we don't typically see that often, or not at least by just with the show standards by itself. So why don't we just you mentioned before the cat? What was it? The first short you ever made was set to a game called what again?
Star Control 2,
and to enslaving to caterpillars that were enslaving everything.
Yeah, it was the Urquan. They like they bop around the galaxy and they fight. Fight races, and if they defeat you, they give you one of two choices. Either you can become their slaves and, like, fight in their army, or they confine you on one planet and put you, like, under a slave shield. Okay. And they're
jerks. Shield.
They're not very sympathetic, guys.
So, we always like to show... Yeah,
video called? called All Hail Princess Celestia?
Yeah, it's like we like to show the very first video a person did when they were making pony videos, and this would be yours.
I'm glad I never get interviewed on here.
Yeah, no, you're not really worth the time to interview, to be honest.
Shut your mouth, you shit.
I'm just being honest. I mean,
anyways, let's continue on with this awesome video. 3, 2, 1, play.
So, I guess the whole story behind this is that it's obvious that I made it in Windows Movie Maker because of the letterboxing.
Yeah.
So.
A lot of people have started on Windows Movie Maker. Mm-hmm. It's just like, I have no idea how to even cut clips, but this is how I'm going to find out. And it's free.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah. My memory's a little hazy, but I seem to remember the video source I used. Every time I would cut it, it would have to re-render the whole thing, so this thing took, like, way longer if I had done it in anything else. But, yeah. Like I said, this was so long ago, I don't even remember exactly the specifics.
Because you just don't want to remember that. You've blocked that memory out of your mind.
Yes.
I don't blame you.
Pretty much. I've...
But, yeah, that was your very first video. Hey, very good. For the first time, I mean, it's just to show Celestia is going to enslave all of ponykind, I'm guessing. And
that's her job, right? She raises the sun and she raises the slaves.
Yeah. I mean, she gets them to do things for her. Like, there's a dragon that's about to destroy our world, and I need you, grad student and grad student friends, to go fix it because I'm too busy doing other things, mostly enslaving the entire other part of the races. Okay, so go do that. But
you could say
she's got the power.
Princess Celestia. I have a theory.
Why
that
are you
Celestia,
bringing?
She's an all powerful. What my fan fiction theories?
Oh, yeah. You're fanning. So we're gonna skip ahead a little bit because one thing I gotta mention before. This is when you were, I think, using Vegas. So we're finally in a non-Windows Movie Maker editing program here, and. It's called Rainbow Dash is a Truthful Pony. And what you do here is you kind of show one thing that was said in the show, show the opposite after that with subsequent clips, and then just bring the joke all together full circle in the end. So why don't we show that first, and we can discuss it.
I will put it in 720p, because we're too good to not do that.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. 3, 2, 1, play.
Now, why don't you tell me all about your issues with Applejack? Come on, Applejack!
You're being unreasonable!
About season 2, I definitely switched over to Vegas.
I don't have any issues with Applejack.
See?
This is just pretty much putting in some little bit of plot holes of the show not necessarily making some connections there.
Mm-hmm.
It's like, oh, I don't have any issues.
But that's what I like about your style there. It's just because you were just doing that in a lot of ways that you're using just the show footage to tell the joke. You're not even, you know, putting any effects in it. You're just cutting clips in a really efficient manner. And that's great. Really like that style of editing.
Yeah. Yeah. when I worked on those videos, I would I'd just watch an episode, and then I'd basically just wait until something hit me that goes, wait, wouldn't it be funny if, or wait a minute, that doesn't sound right, and then I would get on Vegas and make the video, and upload it.
Yeah, this next video.
I like this next video.
No, this next video I actually chose because I just like how much you focused on such an insignificant character. Really, it's
yeah. Well, her. I noticed it like as soon as that scene
they bring it up like, but they never address it again. So it's just like a momentary moment.
Anyways,
uncomfortableness. Anyways,
let's play it. 3, 2, 1, and go.
Oh, this thing.
Yes. You didn't even know what you were watching. Oh, yeah, I remember this, though.
Yeah, I don't know. I seem to have a thing for, movies that have apocalyptic connotations.
Yeah, no.
I don't know about how true that is, but yeah. Deep. Just the unbridled fury of a thousand,
thousand
campfires.
Mm-hmm.
That sounds about right. I don't know what the metric is for jealousy. It's thousand fusion
set
points.
High.
I don't know.
Mm. Yeah.
Green with envy. Whatever.
Wait a minute. So that's why she wears boots
or
steel shoes or whatever they are.
Gold? Yeah. So she doesn't get her feet sullied by dirty commoners' kisses.
Common folk.
As we learned from Rarity in that one episode. But moving on.
Okay.
The next thing is, actually, this was made post-Anthology 2. We haven't even gotten to talking about your involvement with that, but we'll get to it in a sec. This was something you made afterwards, but I really liked, this was actually you kind of branching out and starting to add a little more effects to what you were doing.
Some flair.
There you go. That's a good way to put it. AJ's Brain 2. Brain harder.
I wasn't braining hard enough.
I actually wanted to do this for, Anthology, but I just never got around to it.
Mm-hmm.
Or I was going to do something like it, but I just got put on the back burner.
Okay,
what happened was I did the Applemancer short in place of it.
Ah, okay. A good one.
I like that one, too.
Yeah.
Okay, 3, 2, 1, play.
Applejack, can we talk?
Stupid confirmed.
Crashed onto my balcony after you launched her into the air!
I don't treat Applejack very well in my videos. I've noticed this.
I don't think anyone really does.
I'm also getting the typical trend that you really like short but sweet, You don't like to take the joke and go too long with it, but you like to just get the point across, which is sometimes the best. Those are the videos that link also easiest. People go, hey, check this out.
Because
it gets the point across. You don't have to sit there for 4 minutes to get the joke.
Short and sweet. Now, this is, we could show every little thing, because you got invited into Anthology 2, and actually, why don't we take a little, why don't you just tell us a little bit of how you got invited into that group?
Well, this was during my, I had just gotten into Vegas, and I, a lot of stories that happen when you get a new video editor, I basically just wanted to make as much stuff as possible, as much as I could. So I started uploading a bunch of stuff, and the forum I frequented, I started, actually uploading stuff just for, the sake of showing it to other people to say, hey, I'm making these little shorts, and for a while I was doing the one video a day, but I don't know if I was doing it when you guys invited me, but I showed one, and Dr. Dinosaur, who was the guy who was basically in charge of Anthology 2, he sent me a PM and said, hey, these are really funny. Do you want to join Anthology 2? And I was like, yeah! And that's my story. I started making shorts pretty soon after.
It's kind of like a right time, right place.
I said it exactly like that, too.
Yeah! Did he send you an Imgur link to a picture of a piece of paper with a black hoof on it by any chance?
That short from the no his too. His
yeah but no, I'm talking did he so. Did he send you an actual image from there as like his, part of his message of inviting you in? No.
Oh no, he didn't do that.
Because that's what he did awesome, for me though. And I think maybe YouTube Evids.
Yeah, no. Actually, what happened? Was it you that got invited first, and then
I got invited first, yeah, and yeah. I was like, "Hey, I know this guy named Beavids. He's pretty good at editing and stuff. You should have it on the project." They were like, "Cool," and then that's how pretty much it happened. Yeah. And then Kidney was there too, but then not. Yeah. But anyway.
Yeah.
Yeah, but you know, it was basically a thing for you with right time, right place, because I know the forum you're talking about, Pony Goons, the round stable, either one works. And, yeah, and they were hanging all around there for a while, and it's the same thing with a bunch of people who were just kind of hanging around that forum, happened to be video editors, and they all got invited on board. So, good. Now we can't, you have 7 minutes of Anthology 2 shorts. We're not going to show them all. Oh, you said you recommended this one as the most popular of yours. Right.
Okay.
Go through it. It is Applejack is Stubborn is just the title of the video.
Okay, I got this one.
Yep. You got it.
Okay, who for the North Star?
This one. Three. Go.
AJ, I think you're beating it.
That's from Mortal Kombat, right?
Mm-mm. Nope. I don't think
so. No?
I don't think so.
I'm pretty sure the sound sample is. No?
Fist of the North Star.
Aha.
Oh, he makes that sound in that movie? No, I've seen it.
Yeah,
that movie's over
that's
the
Kenshiro.
Top. It's crazy.
And so then, you took a little bit of a hiatus after Anthology 2. I'm guessing maybe Burnout was part of the cause of that.
Pretty much.
But, and then we got a nice little gem of a movie trailer for Human Horse Movie something. I forget the name. Do you remember it?
Sweet and Ballet?
Yeah. No, that sounds about right. So basically,
or was it
once
the Equestria Girls movie one.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, no, we're talking about, of course, we're talking about when they first started talking about Equestria.
Or was it the first one?
The first one was by, I believe, ZX Insanity. But
yeah, what was the first one that you did?
The first one he ever was Sweet and Ballet.
Sweet and Ballet.
First one I ever did was Sweet and Ballet.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, cool. We're here.
I tried to list them in order as best I could.
Because, you know, everyone's been thinking about Equestria Girls lately.
This was the beginning of a new kind of direction for you as a video editor altogether. So let's begin that. Countdown. Go.
3, 2, 1, go.
Go!
Greetings, sister. I hope the nuclear
Microsoft sound voices.
Why look over there, rude
pretty
sibling?
Much.
It is Rarity.
Make us a dress. If I remember right, what did I use? I used the AT&T.
AT&T?
What are Rarity's legs made out
of? Ever, like, totally.
Cyborg legs?
I don't know.
Well, shave my cat and call me grandma.
He's made out of roaches.
Then this started another show. Well, not started, but Jesus. You hit that nail on the head.
Celestia?
She sure loves that
so
one
quiet
fruit.
Today?
Risks of flowering.
Yeah, that kind of started a trend in all the other Equestria Girl videos.
Godhood.
Now it's a thing forever.
Measure. Oh, God.
You are right.
The law of Akira.
We must summon the great one.
Yeah, I am.
And he's wearing granny pants.
Good job, you.
So.
And then you add, of course.
I basically.
Go ahead.
Well, I mean, there is. I start these things with absolutely just a very vague idea of what I'm going to do, and then I, you know, veered off in another direction. I don't think my original plan was to have, you know, Shaq appear over a
PK Garson.
But that's what happened.
Special thanks
I
to
felt, I felt like that ending was just like a lead up for a chaos dunk to come into
another.
Well,
hold on. We're getting ahead of ourselves there in that department.
Yeah.
Are.
No, I'm not saying that necessarily one's coming. I'm just saying Chaos Dunk is not necessarily what happens with Shaq on screen.
God. Like, but no, it wasn't. No, Shaq had nothing to do with the Chaos Dunk. It is all Charles Barkley and Jordan and all that.
Come on.
So,
CM Dunk.
Shut up! Jesus. Okay. What caused you? So, what. What caused you to basically go in this whole new direction, and when you're making these videos, what's your thought process for making this?
Is there a thought process?
Okay, well, I watched CX Insanity stuff, which was, he made two before I, you know, got started making them. He made Equestria Girls, just all caps and nothing else, and he made Equestria Girls Brag Busters. And people have probably seen that one where Twilight turns into a Reaper and vaporizes Trixie. I love these so much that I decided to make one of my own. So I booted up Vegas, found some vectors of Celestia, Luna, Rarity, and Applejack, and I made that. Afterwards, I figured, you know, that was kind of fun, and it got pretty popular compared to what my videos normally get, so I decided to make the sequel, Party of Gone, which I did. And it was, you know, I established even more of a quote-unquote canon for the rest of the series. And, you know, when I started working on these, I kind of worked like a madman. I almost did these things in almost one sitting. And, you know, so what you see is pretty much completely unfiltered madness. I don't start these things with a plan. If I did, they wouldn't be what they are, so.
In a way, the playing by ears just leads to the madness. Yeah. Essentially. Anyway, go on.
Pretty much. And so, at the end of each one, there's like a little joke.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
At the end of each credits, and what those usually are for me, I don't know what like Jake Wyman or CX Insanity do, but that's usually like a joke I was going to use in the video, but for whatever reason, it didn't fit in. So, I mean, you'll see the one for this one. Mm-hmm.
Man, am I the only one getting like the feedback, or not the feedback, but like the microphone lag?
No, I can hear you guys just fine. I don't know.
Okay.
I mean, we'll fix it in post. Okay, I got secondary recording, dude.
We're all good. Whatever, it's good. Okay. Good. 3, 2, 1, go.
I also like the descriptions you have for these.
Oh yeah.
So
this
fast,
last
was like
episode was found in an abandoned asylum in Detroit. The presence of an illegible Romanian cuneiform and copies of the Necromomicon surrounding the flash drive leaves instigators baffled.
Rainbow Dash, what brings you to my sugary home?
I'm just reporting what I found.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's not my fault the investigators were found dead a week later. Yeah.
Oh no? Pinkie Pie is in trouble. Spike.
The reason why Gummy has that hair is because I couldn't find like normal Super Saiyan hair, so I found that, the 3D kind.
Gummy went Super Saiyan lesbian.
God. That cliff fall on top of her head is probably my favorite part of this one, too.
I like also that, like, Twilight's vector, or, like, the crop out is really blurry, and Celestia's is all, like, nice and crisp.
Oh, the whole reasoning, but that's not like on purpose. I just, there wasn't a good vector of Twilight at the moment. And eventually I kind of became attached to the really crappy vectors, so I kept using them.
Yeah.
You also had like that joke at the very end. It also has to match up in the beat to the final song, doesn't it? Or am I just imagining that?
No, that's on purpose.
I figured as much, but still. You're too thorough for that, Blarg. I wouldn't expect less of you.
Yeah.
Now, here comes the one that really, really got me, like, really into these videos. This was it.
Oh, yeah.
This one.
This is my favorite one I made.
Oh, yeah?
It really is. I don't know if I'm going to be able to top this. I hope one day I will, but not for a while.
I don't know. You came close with something else you did after this that we're going to show, but this still is probably my favorite.
Yeah. Prepare yourselves, people.
Prepare for yourselves.
A thing.
It's one of the best things, so don't have to worry.
It's a word. Okay. Let's go. 3, 2, 1. Go.
One of the hardest part of making these videos is finding shitty elevator music.
Really? That was the hard part?
It is time.
By Disney's kneecaps. The app owning is happening.
Oh,
I have to stop it.
Now, who was the who did the Nicolas Cage thing first?
Twilight.
That was Jake Wyman, but an epic and extremely Zia Consenti came adventure with the name Brad. Jake had the idea to have Brad be Nicolas Cage, and I just kind of added to it.
I can't believe I let you talk me into your crazy quest.
We already stole all the resolution. Pinky has none. Montage.
Hey, at least Gummy got a lot stronger.
Oh God!
I don't care. I'm going home.
That montage right there, that one of those like 2 seconds. It was supposed to be longer.
Well,
but
at least I have you, Twilight.
I got lazy and decided to do something else, which you'll see in a second.
Okay. Jeez. And then it begins. Two enemies enter the ring. Only one will leave unscathed.
This fight scene, just none has been matched in current television. Oh boy.
Nuclear explosion!
By the way, people will get like 5 internet points if you can figure out what the Japanese says.
What in the world, dude?
Oh, and then Gummy with his
friend.
I told you when I saw this, if I ever see you make something this... If you ever make something this good ever again, that ending part, you are putting that into A3. And I would have no excuses otherwise. So, that offer is still there.
That demand,
is still there.
The demands, demands.
Well, not going to disappoint you.
No, you won't. You've already been great.
Yeah.
But that ending sequence was amazing.
Came out of nowhere when I was making it. Literally, I was just in that point where Twilight airs out. And then I was just thinking. And I had an idea, and then I started laughing like a freak. And then I started making the whole thing, and I was just laughing the entire way, like tears were coming down my face as I was making this. And then, when I sat back and looked at it, I'm like, what the hell is wrong with me?
You knew what you were doing was insane, but you were having fun. And that's the important part.
Oh, yes.
And finally, this is a long video.
The last one we're going to show is a six-minute video.
It's nine seconds.
We're showing the entire thing. Because we purposely put this at the end.
Okay.
Also contains one of the best scenes, in my opinion, that you've done for this series.
Wait, did you really go off to go get popcorn?
Seriously, can we just stop the stream of the podcast? We're all going to go get something to eat, right?
Yeah,
it's cool. All right, cool.
Yeah.
Break!
The whole reason I made this was Zia Consenti made one that was called Return of Discord, or something. That's also like six months long, but I made this to show him what for.
Okay. Well, let's start up in three, two, one.
Go.
I should probably buy something for Discord and Fluttershy's honeymoon. What do you think, Spike?
I'm a dog. Discord, glad to see you up and about and in perfectly good health.
Oh no, I don't use that vector of spike enough.
Pegasus! Are we supposed to be scared of the pants? No?
Dear Quill Jack's phone, like, I was the one who killed Discord.
It's a dramatic death scene, except it isn't. Stalker,
sunset shimmer, holy slapping turnips.
And, you know...
Well, can't we talk about this?
What remember is all the Spike fun times doing in the in high school? During this whole scene?
You're the coolest guy ever, not Brad.
I don't know. Dumb and smelly.
I want to ask you all these questions. I know the answer is the same, though.
You are a jerk, Lord. No more talking. No more punching narwhals.
There was a reason.
Today. Look over there.
Probably a bad reason.
Horse?
There was a reason. And
boy, howdy.
People,
that was a
like,
crush with death's unicycle.
Like, made their own theories about what he's doing, and they're all funny as hell.
We're grilling and killing.
Of course he's a drunk.
Excellent. Now is the time to strike deep into the heart of Equestria.
Yeah, Scottish Chrysalis, by the way?
Yeah.
Yeah? Okay.
Yeah, works with the Socialist Empire of Canada, double agent of Emperor Colin Montgomery. Yeah. It's all very elaborate. There's a whole backstory. Yeah. I've written a few novels, I've written, have a family tree, you know, I've sent emails to Drew Carey, fan mail and fan art, and requests to have him on my show, and he just keeps sending me, like, really angry replies, but I still talk to him, though. He doesn't like it.
Burninating the countryside.
I don't know if you've noticed either, but there's also a tendency in all the videos for them to use very weird expressions. Like, toast my spaghetti, shave my cat, and call me grandma, what the Larson is that, etc., etc.
And then you did this.
Dragon Ball Z.
No.
Sound effect,
this
perfect.
Is... Okay, you know, you're right. I thought you were referencing that. No, but this is... Someone's play Shut Up and Jam Gaiden, huh? Or at least heard of it.
Yeah, you could say that. the part that matters.
It dwarfs the entire castle. Oh. Sir.
Yeah, this was fun. This was just fun to make. And I say this for all my views, but really, I love doing this.
Oh, I can tell. This is the type of stuff that's just so off-the-wall crazy that you can't help but, like you were saying before, you were laughing and crying while you were making it just because you know how ridiculous it is, but it's still just amazingly fun to make. It's great.
And after this comes the feels.
Yeah.
Well, we can't have any feature-length movie without, like, the part where you're supposed to cry.
You picked the best song.
You can cry now.
No, I will. I'll stand up and I'll salute. Where's my beret and my eye patch?
I got my beard on.
Largalt.
The best of times.
Chaos times. Memory.
Big man's wrinkle. He lived to muffin.
Yeah. Well, I mean, that's his real name.
Cry every time.
I don't know how you missed it.
I didn't pay attention enough.
Yeah, it's like in the first episode, I think. I don't know.
That pixelated.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah.
And then,
I think I could probably get better vectors, but I've grown to love the pixel.
That's part of the charm thing.
Oh, wait.
Then you followed it up with a classic.
Hello. Yes, This is Chrysalis.
And the joke on this one at the end is a little different.
But I got distracted by a bug zapper.
You have to have played a certain game series to maybe understand what's going on.
The loss of my original character Swarm was a setback. It won't take long to fan fiction up some more, though. No, I don't think she was aware. She was too blind from angry punching.
The funny thing is, I made this bit actually before the rest of the video. Like the whole her getting killed, her getting distracted by a bug zapper, that actually kind of played into her getting vaporized by a crashing battle cruiser. I didn't even plan for that, but that's how it happens.
But you had to
kill like a metaphysical force at work.
Well, this would naturally have to come at the ending anyways, after the credits.
I'll give you regular status updates from
you already knew that, I would hope.
Mrs. Faust.
Maybe. Sometimes I just wake up. When I wake up, these things are finished.
So, does that mean that Chrysalis is Ocelot in your whole scenario here?
Maybe. So many times.
How many times can she quadruple cross everyone?
That was all the videos
we had.
Wait. He's like,
we got one more.
Wait.
We got one more. It has to be played today. It's content. And it has to be played today. It has to be played today.
Yeah, Roro, fight the power.
Roro, fight the power! Roro, fight the power!
It's fine now. But
just calm down. Just calm down. That's what I'm telling the internet right now. Okay. Oh, it was you.
It wasn't me.
Now you messed up.
I didn't mess up. It wasn't me. Anyways. And we can show one last thing we should show. I mean, people have already seen this, Feedsy's thing. Why not just show it one more time? Because it's pretty amazing, and, you know, why not?
Okay. It is. For some reason, YouTube's special, and it's like, it didn't make it special, but it just goes like, oh, you wanted to go to Corridor Digital's page? Okay. Okay, 720p, let's see if this works.
Okay.
Okay. Start it up in 3, 2, 1. Is the stream okay?
I hope so. Okay.
3, 2.
Go.
I think this is like, if you go out into space far enough, this is what you see. Just ponies. Horses, small equines, maybe a camel or two. This is obviously not the case, but Chronicles has always had a word that meant something a little bit different on the internet. But, you know, that's another story for another time.
Mm-hmm. No, everything about this is so just so well done, so impressive. And that's just... I don't know how he does it. He does it so quickly, too. He just ups his game every video, and it's just amazing.
He's a wizard, obviously.
He kind of is a wizard.
He's like, well, I mean, he sold his soul to Discord to make good pony videos. I mean, obviously.
Mm-hmm. I mean, that's a possibility, of course.
No, I mean, it could be Cthulhu or, you know, maybe Thor. But, you know, there's definitely dark magic at work.
Yeah.
No, I'm not complaining.
I really do also, yeah, I also enjoy the song Fuzog's made for the whole thing. I mean, it's a little bit of a remix off one of his other songs, Make It Special, but I really actually like this a lot better than that. And just, it's catchy, it's great. Everything, great. I love this video. It's amazing.
Everything is so magical.
I love this story!
Well,
so I think that's pretty much all we got. I think we should bow out while the getting's good.
Okay.
Well,
it was a fun episode.
It was.
Thank you, BlogArt.
Thank you. Thank you for showing us into your world of insanity.
You're welcome. You're welcome to come back anytime. Don't know why you would. But yeah.
You know, I don't know if I don't think I'm really going to do
you have free
podcast
tickets.
Anymore. I have free tickets to your podcast whenever I want to come over here? Oh, sweet. Thanks, BlogArt.
You have free tickets to my brain.
Oh, okay.
So, have fun with that.
Well, that's... I don't know if I want to go there. Out. I could literally die. I'm just
sick.
Yeah, you probably would.
Mm-hmm.
It's happened.
Committing murder in your mind? Not so good.
Also, to you... Yeah... To you crazy internet people who have been watching and been subjected to what I've had to show you, I'm sorry, but, you know, the internet basically demands I have to show you this. I don't have any control anymore.
Why are you such a bad liar? You're not sorry for a damn thing you've done, and it's okay.
I agree. But,
just a voice keeps saying, horses, horses, and I have to obey it. So this is what I do.
All right.
Seems to be the trend for all
well,
of
thanks
us.
A lot, guys. Stay tuned for Brony Breakdown, Saber, and Paleo. Have a good night. See you next time.